There are about 1.5 billion cows on this planet. That's one cow for every 5 people on Earth. We keep them for dairy and meat. And they're a climate problem that we've struggled to solve. Every year, each one of those cows is estimated to release up to 220 pounds of methane, mostly when they burp. That's about 4% of all greenhouse gas emissions that are warming our planet from burping cows. You've probably heard a few solutions to this, like trying to convince people to lower their beef intake or switch to meat alternatives. But instead of trying to convince billions of humans to change their diets, some researchers are focusing on the diet of the cows. And a promising solution might come in the form of seaweed. This video is presented by Delta Airlines. One of the reasons cows produce so much methane is because their specialized digestive tract. It allows them to digest tough plant material like grass, hay, and other vegetation. Their stomach consists of 4 compartments. The largest one, the rumen, acts sort of as a storage unit where food can sit and ferment. Microbes in this area break down the food using a process called enteric fermentation. This process provides the animal with the nutrients and energy it needs, but it also produces methane as waste. And the cow burps it out, which makes the earth a little bit hotter. Here's the thing, though. Methane is literally waste, and changing the diet of the cow can change how much of it is produced. Foods like grass or hay stay in the rumen longer and produce more of it, whereas carbohydrate-rich foods like corn produce less methane. But the goal here isn't to completely change the diet of all of these cows that we're feeding. We can just tweak it a little.
We've been doing a lot of work on feed additives to try to reduce enteric methane emissions.
Hermias Cabrab is the associate dean at UC Davis in the College of Agriculture and Environmental Sciences. In 2018, he led a study that tested how cows reacted to a certain additive, seaweed. Specifically, red seaweed, which grows naturally in tropical and subtropical ocean regions. Back in 2016, researchers in Australia had found that sprinkling the seaweed on cow feed could potentially reduce methane emissions by over 95%. And in 2021, Kibrab and his team were able to replicate the study in live animals in California.
That completely blew my mind when I saw how effective it was.
The final results found that the seaweed could reduce methane emissions by 82%.
At first, I couldn't believe it because I've never seen anything like that before.
This specific species of red seaweed contains high amounts of a compound called bromoform. When a cow ingests it, it suppresses the enzyme that makes methane. And the cows, they don't even notice a change in their dinners. The seaweed is dried and sprinkled onto the food they're used to. They can still get all the nutrients they need, produce milk, and grow, but the waste is reduced. Other additives work too, like fatty acids, which reduce methane by lowering the carbohydrate content and reducing a specific parasite in the rumen known as protozoa. And oregano was found to reduce the number of bacteria in the rumen to limit methane production. But so far, out of all the additives tested, seaweed has been the most effective. The best news is that scaling up the growth of seaweed doesn't technically drain other resources like fresh water or fertilizer, since we can grow it in the ocean. Growing seaweed could also combat other issues like ocean acidification, another climate problem caused by rising levels of carbon dioxide. But there's still a lot of research left to do, including figuring out how to dry it and package it and ship it at a low cost. Like, how do we effectively get seaweed from a subtropical area to, say, Maine, without adding tons of emissions with shipping, that is. If you didn't know, seaweed is super heavy when wet. But once we figure out the logistics, it's over. We solved it. The cows are content and the planet is saved. Except, not at all, obviously. For one, this doesn't appear to be a one-size-fits-all solution. Recently, another Australian study found that the same red seaweed only cut methane emissions by under 30%. Now, granted, that's still a reduction, which is good news, but maybe less of a miracle than we hoped. Others are urging researchers to slow down on red seaweed because of the bromoform. In its pure form, the EPA has reported that it could be dangerous to human health if ingested. Luckily, studies so far haven't found it at dangerous levels in milk or in meat from cows eating the seaweed additive. But studies still need to be done on how it might affect the cows long term. So it's not a silver bullet. But thankfully, seaweed's not our only option.
I think this is just one of several solutions that are being looked at the moment.
And overall, there's a big push for change. In 2021, 150 countries, including the United States, signed the United Nations Global Methane Pledge, which aims to reduce methane emissions by 30% by 2030.
It's becoming more and more clear now that we won't get there unless we tackle enteric methane emissions.
In an ideal world, we'd have less livestock. But getting people to change their habits isn't always the most straightforward or quickest solution. The work of searching for solutions to the climate crisis needs to be multifaceted.
Within a year or two, you will see quite a lot of different activities, different solutions that's going to come up.
And that could be one less cow burp at a time.